Let us take this example from one of the textbook, excess problem. Here three forces are acting at O point, so it is concurrent force system. In it, what we have to find? Find the resultant of the given system. Here one hook is there, so in it at O point three forces are acting. So for this diagram we need to do the resolution of force diagram. So first I will take one diagram. In it, I will take the angles with horizontal, similar to the previous example. Here I took all angles with the horizontal. Now do here. So this is x-axis, 80 Newton force. How much angle it is making? It is given with horizontal only 30. And next force is 50 Newtons. It is also acting with horizontal 45, no need to change. So 45, which is an extra force 60 Newtons. It is in upper direction like this, 60 Newtons. Now what is the angle with horizontal with this? If you are taking this line, horizontal line, total is 30 plus 25, it is 55 degrees total angle. Now take with the horizontal 55 degrees. Okay, now do the resolution of force diagram. Resolution of forces means we are dividing the components, inclined forces, into two components. One is horizontal, one is vertical. Just do one graph. Okay, so take the first force, 80 Newton inclined force. It has one horizontal component and one vertical component, and this inclined force is making 30 degrees with the horizontal. For finding the horizontal vertical component, I am taking one example here. As I mentioned in the previous class, if the force is inclined to some angle, it has two components. One is horizontal component, it is acting along this line, and one vertical component, it is acting along this line. Both x and y values are positive. Now here, how to find the cos value and how to find the sine vertical value? Now here, yesterday I have explained, make the triangle, okay? You just make the triangle here. Now this is the horizontal component, vertical, whatever it is coming, we have to mark here. Okay, FV value, FH value. Okay, this is the first force, that's why FH1, FV1. Now by using this triangle, okay, so this is F1 value, magnitude F1. And we need to find this horizontal value, so we can apply cos 30. In this triangle, cos 30 is equal to FH1 by F1. FH1 by F1. F1 quantity will be given. So we need to find FH1. FH1 is equal to F1 cos 30. Okay, we can find this value by using the given values. Now, next we need to find the vertical component. How to find vertical component? Fy1, okay, V1. So Fv1 we have to take here in this triangle. How to find the value vertical component? Sine 30 is equal to Fv1 by F1. Fv1 by F1. Now here we need to take Fv1 value is equal to F1 into sine 30. Sine 30. Okay. Now here there are two components for this force. Okay, horizontal, vertical. Now how to do this diagram by taking these two components. Horizontal component. This is the horizontal component. It is acting in this direction. F1 cos 30. And vertical component is F1 sine 30. Now instead of this diagram, we can take these two components. Okay, instead of this inclined force, we can take two components. So similarly, we have to change this inclined component also into one vertical and one horizontal. Here also one horizontal and one vertical. Like that, we have to divide entire diagram in terms of all horizontal components and all vertical components. Okay, this process is called resolution of forces, means dividing this force, inclined force, into vertical component and horizontal component. So let us take So I am taking 80 Newton force. Horizontal component is in this direction, vertical is in this direction. Now I am taking 80 cos 30, this angle is 30. Horizontal component 80 cos 30, vertical is 80 sin 30. Next force is 60 newtons, 55 degrees. Horizontal component is in this direction. Directions are important. If the force is in the first Q means coordinate means you have to take horizontal here, vertical here. So 60 cos 55. Vertical is 60 sin 55. Okay. Now for this force, it is in the third Q, third coordinate. Horizontal component is in this direction, vertical is downward. Okay. Horizontal is 50 cos 45 and vertical is in downward direction because it is in the third cube, 50 sin 45. Here I have written. Now for this we have to find sigma. Finding the resultant, we need to find sigma FH value and sigma Fe value. As we have discussed previously in this example, what is sigma FH? Sigma FH means sum of all horizontal components. So here I will write sum of all because all are in the positive direction. Okay. So first force is, we can take any order because all we are taking sum, 50 cos 45. First force. Second force is 80 cos 30. Third force is 60 cos 55. So by using calci do this, we will get some value. Similarly, next one is sigma Fe is 0. So two components is upward. So upward forces I am taking positive. For downward forces I am taking negative in case of vertical. So two components are positive. First force is 80 sin 30 plus 60 sin 55, downward force minus 50 sin 45. Now find out by using calculator these two values. We will get this sigma FH is 139, sigma FE is 55.36 newtons. Now resultant formula is like this. We will get this value. Now here I will tell one important thing. Sigma FH we got positive value. Sigma FE is also positive value. So we can take sigma FH value is like this. And sigma FE is in like this. Okay. And now this is the resultant. We did already here. This resultant force is 141.3 newtons. How much angle it is making with horizontal means. So we can call it as this is direction of the resultant force. Now previously we took tan phi. Tan phi is equal to sigma FV by sigma FH. What is sigma FV value? We took 55.36. Sigma FH value is 139. Phi is equal to the required angle. Tan inverse of 55.36 by 139. Now the resultant is 21 degrees 0.71. This is the method of finding the resultant of the given diagram.